He can hold his ground and chase you down. I'm Frost, and this is Tools of the Trade. The passive. As Hachi lands basic attacks, he regenerates more mana. For starters, you don't have to buy mana pods. Just 8 mana pods purchased over an entire game is 400 gold. That's 400 gold you save just for playing Hachi. And if you're not buying mana potions, you can buy mixed potions. You combine that with a health potion, and you can heal all that damage up that you're face tanking in the early game while you're being aggressive. And if you want to, you're afraid of 4 people ganking your lane within the first few seconds of the game, then grab a ward. He's probably the only hunter that can get away with that. It lets you spam your abilities so long as you're mindful of your basic attacks and you're hitting either minions or gods or buff camps. All that mana is going to come right back. It also helps you get around the map more. Wait, how's that work? You can literally use your dash to get into the jungle, grab a camp, and come back. You'll get that MP5, you'll get that mana right back. So with just that extra mana in the early game, you will have more health than your opponent because of how you're going to buy potions, you will have more damage because you can spam your abilities more, and you're going to be more mobile because you can spam your dash. The one, enhanced basic attacks. Your next few shots go out further, they do more damage up close, less damage further off, but more damage than normal shots. Pretty good for poke during the laning phase, and while this is active, essentially you have more range than the average hunter, so you're more dangerous. Or because it does telegraph that you turn the steroid on, people will stay further away from you than the average hunter. And the two, a banner comes down and does more damage in an area. And while you or your allies stand in this, you get increased attack speed. And while it is good for just pure damage alone, it's best when you can utilize that attack speed. And when you use it for poke, make sure you put it in a spot where you can get to it and fight from within it. If you have to miss, at least miss it near you. Because if you throw it out there, and worse, if you miss, you're gonna get run over. Your three, you dash forward, you go through all enemies, you're doing damage, and then at the end of your dash, you do a 360 with your sword and do damage again. And if the enemy is hit with both instances of damage, you get a nice little stun. And what every Hachi is supposed to do is after you hit the dash, you do a 180 with your camera so that you're facing the enemy after they're stunned. It's good for getting away, it's good for going in on someone. Level for level, it does as much damage as your two if you're getting both procs of damage, but you don't get an attack speed steroid afterwards. And as a general rule, I don't advise doing damage with your face as a hunter. You're not an assassin. And the ultimate, he goes up on a horse, the horse dashes forward, he's crowd control immune, the horse is not very good for sharp turns, and you can aim a cone that when you fire, launches arrows at whoever is in the cone. This is also where you are going to dismount your horse. It's a massive cone. Once you press fire, anyone within that cone is going to get shot, and it hits hard. And it slows. Worst part of it is, or best part, depending on what side of it you're on, it brings a hunter closer to you. He does decent damage with abilities and shreds you with auto attacks. Character is now standing next to you after you thought you got away. Or maybe now you try to get away. He probably has his dash. So three things stand out. One, attrition. He's not going to be running out of mana anytime soon. And if he builds lifesteal, he can last in lane for a very long while. He can keep you at bay with those extra long shots. If you jump on him, he drops a banner on your head, and now you've got to contend with increased attack speed. He can dash through you, slap you, stun you. And if all else fails, he rides off into the sunset with his horse. And if he's chasing you down, he can dash you, slap you, drop a banner on your head. Now you have to contend with increased attack speed, and when you try to run away, he runs you over with his horse. That is perhaps one of his strongest traits, because he can position himself to continue to pelt you with basic attacks, the strongest part of any hunter. Three things in mind. Attempt in the early game to out-sustain your opponent. Spam those abilities knowing that you're going to get your mana back if you hit those basics. You have a lot of space control, so if the enemy backs off, you can push them down to their tower line. You can go into their jungle invading. Your jungler can go in and invade. Or if they back off, you can let the wave sit in the middle of the lane and zone them out. Or if you don't want to push up so far, you can decide to just hold your ground. Clear the wave normally and save your banner for in case if somebody wants to step up to you, you have an attack speed steroid. And if they get too close for comfort, you just pony on out. And if they draw the short straw, you can chase them down with your horse. That horse helps you control the lane, and your passive helps you to sustain, but your passive needs you to land your auto attacks. To land those auto attacks, you need to practice, so go out there and become the god you were meant to be.